And the pledge of allegiance will be Mr. Cloche.
Lord, we count it a privilege to be here tonight in order to represent this different school districts and this school board. We go to you and ask you for your wisdom, knowledge, and understanding for all the issues that are coming before us tonight. We thank you for your guidance and leadership. We thank you for your protection, Lord God, over the students of this parish and their families. Lord, again, we just want to thank you for the privilege of being able to be here and to serve tonight. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, sir. Roll call.
Mr. Michael LaGuard.
Here.
Mr. Gregory Harding. Mr. Matthew Ford.
Here.
Mrs. Debbie Benoit. Mr. Don Crowdis. Dr. Bud Cloche.
Here.
Mr. Roger Dale DeHart.
Here.
Dr. Maybelle Trahan.
Here.
And Mr. Dane Vosann.
Here.
Madam President, you have a quorum.
Thank you. At this time, we will have a moment of silence for those employees that have gone before us.
Isaac Piku, retired school teacher. Marie Foray, retired school custodian. Dorothy Ober, retired school librarian. Helen Mills, retired master teacher. Barbara Rogers, retired school teacher. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Vosann. Item number 5, approval of minutes of special school board meeting on December 19, 2023, regular school board meeting of January 9, 2024, and special school board meeting of January 23, 2024.
So moved.
The board approved the minutes of the special school board meeting of December 19, 2023. Regular school board meeting of January 9, 24, special school board meeting of January 23, 24. Do I have a motion?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. DeHart has a motion, second by Mr. Ford.
Yes, ma'am.
Any public comment? Ms. DeHart?
No, ma'am. Thank
Mr.
you.
Mr. Ford?
No, ma'am.
Any other board members? Any objections? No, none heard, so ordered. Item number 6 is going to be again postponed. Mr. Hamner is at a condemnation meeting at the council office tonight. He cannot make it. Announcements number 7. February 1st through 29th is African American History Month. February 5th through the 9th is National School Counseling Week. February 12th through the 18th is our Mardi Gras holidays. Everybody, please be safe. On the 20th, we have our committee meetings at 5 o'clock, beginning with education, technology, and policy, then finance, insurance, and Section 16 lands, followed by executive committee, and then finally buildings, food service, and transportation committee. On the 5th of March, we have our regular school board meeting at 6 o'clock. Item 8A, Buildings, Food Service, and Transportation Committee report. Mr. Vosann.
Thank you, Madam President. The Buildings, Food Service, and Transportation Committee met immediately following the 5 p.m. special school board meeting on Tuesday, January 23, 2024, in the boardroom of the school board office with the following members. Myself as chair, Mr. LaGuard as vice chair, Dr. Maybelle Trahan. Also in attendance were Mr. Cloche, interim school board member, Mr. Ford, Mr. Harding, Ms. Benoit, Mr. Crowdis, Mr. DeHart, Superintendent Ogeron, and members of his staff. Recommendation number 1, the committee recommends that the board approve the request of Louisiana Lady Hornets 2 AAU basketball team to waive policy file E1.6, use of school facilities relative to the usage fees for school facilities for the Oaklawn Middle School gym for the 24-25 basketball season, February 7, 2024 to February 6, 2025, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Monday through Thursdays and some Saturdays and Sundays, if needed, for practices only, provided that the organization reimburse Terrebonne Parish School District for all related custodial costs, all necessary insurance, nonprofit status, and all other school board policy requirements are met, and approval is obtained from the school's principal.
So moved.
So moved, Dr. Trahan. Second, Mr. Lagarde. Any public comments? Dr. Trahan?
No, sir.
Mr. Lagarde? Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number two, the committee recommends that the board enter a bus lease agreement between Lacerte and Terrebonne Parish School Board effective February 7, 2024 through December 31, 2024 to provide bus usage for the Lacerte Mentoring Program, provided buses shall run during normal operating hours on weekdays as needed, mileage reimbursement at a per mile fee equal to 50% of the cost of 1 gallon of fuel at the time of travel, with a minimum per mileage fee of $2.25 per mile driven, provide and pay bus driver approved by Terrebonne Parish School Board, provided all necessary insurance requirements are met, and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto. So move, Dr. Trahan. Second, Mr. Lagarde. Any public comments? Dr. Trahan?
No, sir.
Mr. Lagarde?
No, sir.
Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number three, the committee recommends that the board approve and accept the lowest bid received, meaning all specifications for the Terrebonne High School softball field project from Foray Contracting Group, LLC, P.O. Box 70, Thibodaux, Louisiana, 70302, in the amount of $149,053. Accept alternate number one to provide and install clay blocks below the pitcher's mound and batter's catcher's box in the amount of $6,128, and establish a total budget project in the amount of $191,016. Funds to be derived from the building, food, and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So move.
So move, Mr. DeHart. Second, Mr. Ford. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
No, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Ford?
I did have a question about this one, but I guess I don't see anyone that's here from this project. So it's just about the clay blocks. Generally,
he's out in the audience.
Oh, I didn't see you. You must have been looking down at the moment. Maybe it was the light reflecting off your head that blinded me.
That's what I was going to say. It was blinding you. Good evening. Andy Positary, GFP Architects.
Hey. So usually with these, they'll get extra sets of blocks to keep for the coaching staff for the future, because those clay blocks do get worn out.
Right.
Is that something that's included in the cost of this, or?
We did in this particular bid package. We did not specify extra stock, but that's something that we can talk with Foray about. I'm not sure how the orders come. I'm sure it's not individual blocks. So if there's a certain amount of grouping, we can certainly talk to them about retaining some extra.
So, yeah. You know, a lot of times we'll have a weather event that, you know, gets a lot of rain.
Sure.
And it'll flood it out. And let's say we have a tournament coming up and they need to fix it all of a sudden.
Yeah.
If they have it on hand, they don't have to go through the waiting process.
No, that's a good idea. Well, I can get with Mr. Foray about that.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Any other board members? Thank you, Mr. Positary.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number four, the committee recommends that the board approve and accept the lowest bid received, meaning all specifications for the warehouse generator project from Ernest P. Bro Electrical, LLC, 2812 Broken Arrow Road, New Iberia, Louisiana, 70560. In the amount of $448,000, and establish a total project budget in the amount of $532,690.40. Funds to be derived from the Child Nutrition Program Fund and the General Operating Fund, and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So move.
So move, Mr. DeHart. Second, Mr. Lagarde. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
No, sir.
Mr. Lagarde?
No, sir.
Other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number five, the committee recommends that the board approve and accept the lowest bid received, meaning all specifications for the Hurricane Ida contents replacements utility storage shed bid in response to Hurricane Ida from CNS Sales, LLC, DBA Dirksen Portable Buildings, 808 Pickard Road, Cottage Grove, Tennessee, 38224, in the amount of $122,710. Funds to be derived from FEMA reimbursement funds, $110,439, and local funds, $12,271.
So move,
Mr. DeHart.
Second.
Second, Mr. Ford. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
The only comment I make for the public information, it's a bunch of buildings at different schools, so it's parish-wide and have a storm damage.
Okay, yep, very good.
Thank you.
Mr. Ford?
I have an additional comment. I know this is from Dirksen and they're located in Tennessee. However, it's the local vendor that set up the purchase and is facilitating it, so some of that money is staying here in our community. I know we like to spend money in our own community, so I just wanted to make that clear. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ford. Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number six, the committee recommends that the board approve the substantial completion dated January 10, 2024for the building repair project at Acadian Elementary School and ratify change order number two for additional canopy replacements and repairs and increase the contract time by 10 days to January 10, 2024 in the amount of $22,020.96, subject to the punch list. Upon completion of the punch list and final inspection, balancing change order and receipt of the lien-free certificate, authorize the release of retainage, and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto. So move, Dr. Traha. Second, Mr. Lagarde. Any public comments?
Good.
Dr. Traha?
No, sir.
Mr. Lagarde?
No, sir.
Other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number seven, the committee recommends that the board approve the substantial completion dated January 4, 2024 for the building repair project at the West Park Administration Building, subject to the punch list. Upon completion of the punch list and final inspection, balancing change order and receipt of the lien-free certificate, authorize the release of retainage, and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So move.
So move, Mr. DeHart. Second, Dr. Traha. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
No comment.
Dr. Traha?
No, sir.
Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number eight, the committee recommends that the board approve and accept the following change orders for Hurricane Ida recovery projects and authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So move.
So move, Dr. Traha. Second, Mr. Lagarde. Any public comments? Dr. Traha?
No, sir.
Mr. Lagarde?
No, sir.
Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number nine, the committee recommends that the board approve and accept the following change orders for Hurricane Ida recovery projects and authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So move.
So move, Mr. DeHart. Second, Mr. Harding. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
No, sir.
Mr. Harding? Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number 10. The committee recommends that the board approve the substantial completion dated January 22, 2024 for the hurricane repair project at East Houma, Legion Park, Coto Bayou Blue, Village East, and DuLarge Elementary Schools, and ratify change order number two to increase the contract time by 66 calendar days from November 17, 2023 to January 22, 2024, subject to the punch list. Upon completion of the punch list and final inspection, balancing change order and receipt of the lien-free certificate, authorize the release of retainage and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So move.
So move, Mr. DeHart.
Second.
Dr. Traha. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
No, sir. Not at this time.
Dr. Traha?
No, sir.
Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number 11, the committee recommends that the board assess liquidated damages to Cotton Commercial USA, Inc. in the amount of $100 per day as per contract on the hurricane repair project at the TPSD administrative buildings. Due to the contractor failing to substantially complete the repairs by the substantial completion deadline, with no just cause for a deadline extension from January 13, 2024 until the actual date of substantial completion, and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So move.
So move, Mr. DeHart. Second, Mr. Harding. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
It's unfortunate we have to do this, but this is to keep things in line. If not, other contractors will take advantage of this.
Yes, sir.
So we need to put it in perspective.
Mr. Harding? Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number 12, the committee recommends that the board approve and accept the following change orders and authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So moved.
So moved, Dr. Trahan. Second, Mr. Lagarde. Any public comments? Dr. Trahan?
No, sir.
Mr. Lagarde?
No, sir.
Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Recommendation number 13, the committee recommends that the board approve and accept change order number one for the Oaklawn Middle School window replacement project in the amount of $2,019.60 to add window in boys' PE room 629 per state fire marshal. Funds to be derived from American Rescue Plan Act, ARPA, ESSER 3, and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So moved,
Mr. DeHart. Second, Dr. Trahan. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
No, sir.
Dr. Trahan?
No, sir. I'm just glad to see we're moving along at Oaklawn.
Me too.
Yes, absolutely. Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. And recommendation number 14, the committee recommends that the board approve the substantial completion dated January 23, 2024 for the HVAC replacement project at Mulberry Elementary School. Subject to the punch list, upon completion of the punch list and final inspection, balancing change order and receipt of the lien free certificate, authorize the release of retainage, and further authorize the board president to sign all necessary documents pertaining thereto.
So moved.
So moved, Mr. DeHart. Second, Mr. Harding. Any public comments? Mr. DeHart?
No, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Harding? Any other board members? Any objections? Hearing none, motion passes. Then we had project managers and architects present on the committee night. There being no further business to come before BFT, the meeting was adjourned at 7:22 p.m. I turn it back over to you, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Wazan. Item 8B on the agenda, Education, Technology, and Policy Committee. Our chairperson is not there tonight. So is our co-chair going to be handling? Mr. Harding.
Thank you, Dr. Trahan. Education, Technology, and Policy Committee met immediately following 5 p.m. school board meeting at Building Food Service and Transportation Committee meeting on Tuesday, January 23rd, 2024, in the boardroom of the school board office with the following members present: Ms. Benoit, a chairman, myself, Vice Chairman Gregory Harding, Mr. Roger DeHart, committee member. Also intended were Dr. Trahan, Diane Vazan, Dr. Budd, Ms. Clotter, board member Matthew Ford, and Superintendent Bud Ogeron, and members of the staff. Recommendation number one, the committee recommended the board approve and accept as presented the following revised policy file, B-14, administrative record.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. DeHart.
Second.
Who seconded? Okay, second, Mr. Lagarde. Anyone in the audience would like to discuss that issue? Mr. DeHart?
No, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Lagarde?
No, sir.
Any board member? Objection, injection, hearing none, so ordered. Recommendation number two, the committee recommend that the board approve and accept and present the following revised policy file, F-10- probation.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Vazan, second by Mr. Lagarde. Anyone else would like to discuss that recommendation? Mr. Vazan?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Lagarde? Any board member would like to discuss that issue? Are there any objections? Hearing none, so ordered. Committee recommendation number three, the committee recommend that the board approve, accept as presented the following revised policy file, G-11-4, parent conference.
So moved.
Moved by Dr. Babin, second by Mr. DeHart. Okay, anyone else would like to discuss that issue? Dr. Babin?
No, sir.
Mr. DeHart?
No, sir.
Any board member?
No
objection? Hearing none, so ordered. Recommendation number four. Committee recommended the board approve and accept as presented the following revised policy file, H 2023-36G School Wellness. Mr. Vizad, move by Mr. Vizad, second by Mr. Legard. Anyone in the audience would like to discuss that recommendation? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you do.
Yes, ma'am. State your name and your address for the record, ma'am.
Shawna Hale. Address is 228 Tara Kane Drive, Houma.
Yeah.
Okay. So it looks like the change to the policy or the amendment is just to include the underlined portion, each school that includes grades K to 5 shall provide at least 15 minutes of recess consisting of supervised, unstructured, free play each school day. So that's the change, the amendment?
Yes.
Okay, so I would just like to add, or just ask you to also consider that Bessie has taken a position on withholding recess from students as punishment, and they have stated their position in the content standards, so if I'll just read their position. It says it is not acceptable to withhold students from participation in physical education classes or recess for poor behavior or to make up work absences. So I'd just like to ask that the board would consider that, including that in the recommendation or the change to the policy, so that there was some confusion. I spoke to someone about this, and there was some confusion as to what shall provide meant, and they kind of thought that shall provide meant shall provide an opportunity, that we would give them an opportunity for recess, but if they didn't meet classroom expectations, we could take that 15 minutes away. So I would just like the board to consider adding Bessie's position on the matter, to include that we give them 15 minutes of recess, but also to include that we don't take it away for poor behavior.
You want to add that, Mr. Osorun?
No.
My recommendation is to approve it as is and let us revisit this as a committee, as a staff.
Okay.
And, matter of fact, we plan to meet tomorrow to discuss some of the concerns. That would be one of them.
Okay, I appreciate that.
And we could always adjust if needed. This is a forethought policy, by the way.
Okay.
So we're kind of going with what they recommend.
Okay.
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 Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Anyone from the audience want to discuss that issue? I think it was you, Mr. Legard, that no, I'm sorry, I'm a little rusty at this. I haven't done it in a while. Mr. Vizad, who seconded it? Mr. Legard, okay. Any other board member? Are there any objections? Hear none, so ordered. Recommendation number 5, the committee recommend that the board approve and accept as presented the following revised policy file E-1, 1E, use of automatic extended defibrillator, AED, and cardiac emergency plan. Move by Mr. Vizad.
Second.
Second by Mr. Legard. Anyone in the audience would like to discuss that recommendation? Mr. Vizad, Mr. Legard, any board member? Are there any objection? Hear none, so ordered. Recommendation number 6, committee recommend the board approve and accept as presented the following revised policy file H-3.6, Student Health Service. Move by Dr. Trahan.
Second.
Second by Mr. Dehart. Anyone in the audience would like to discuss that issue? Dr. Babbitt? Mr. Dehart?
No.
Any board member? Are there any objection? Hear none, so ordered. That being no more further business brought before this committee, I turn this back over to you, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Harding. Item 8C, Finance, Insurance, and Section 16 Lands. Mr. Board.
Thank you, Madam President. The Finance, Insurance, and Section 16 Land Committee met immediately following the 5:00 p.m. special school board meeting, Buildings, Food Service, and Transportation Committee, and the Education, Technology, and Policy Committee meetings on Tuesday, January 23rd, 2024. In the boardroom of the school board office with the following members present, myself as chairman, Mr. Don Crowder as vice chairman, Dr. Bud Cloche as interim school board member and committee member. Also in attendance were Dr. Maybell Trahan, Mr. Dane Voisin, Ms. Debbie Benoit, Mr. Greg Harding, Mr. Roger Dale Dehart, Superintendent Bubba Osorun, and members of his staff. Recommendation number 1, the committee recommends that the board approve the following revised budgets for the General Operating Fund, 1-cent Sales Tax Fund, Half-cent Sales Tax Fund, Child Nutrition Program Fund, and Special Revenue Fund for the 2023-2024 fiscal year.
So moved.
Moved by Mr. Cloche.
Second.
Second by Mr. Dehart. Any public comment on this? Mr. Cloche? Mr. Dehart?
No, sir. Thank you.
I did have one comment on this, or a couple of comments. I was contacted by someone who saw the budget, and they were asking with regards to the increase, and they were asking if it was the pay increase that we implemented. That has not taken effect yet. However, with the bus driver, the increase, which was retroactive, a good portion of the money is going to the salaries in the budget. The increase is with that in consideration.
Yes, sir. As well as the 5%.
And the 5%, yes, exactly. So the 10% that we did, the increase, that doesn't start until July 1st. So that'll be in the next fiscal year's up and coming budget.
Yes, sir.
Any other board members?
Nope.
Any objections? Hearing none, so ordered. There being no further business to come before the board, before the Finance, Insurance, and Section 16 Lands Committee meeting, the meeting is adjourned, and I turn it over to Dr. Mabel.
Thank you, Mr. Ford. Item 8D, Executive Committee Report of January 23rd, 2024. Dear members of the board, the Executive Committee met immediately following the 5 p.m. Special School Board meeting, Buildings, Food Service, and Transportation Committee, Education, Technology, and Policy Committee, Finance, Insurance, and Section 16 Lands Committee on Tuesday, January 23rd, 2024, in the boardroom of the school board office with the following members present. Myself, President, Mr. Dane Voisin, Vice President, Mr. Michael Lagarde was absent that evening. Also in attendance were Mr. Cloche, interim school board member, Ms. Benoit, Mr. Ford, Mr. Dehart, Mr. Crowdis, Mr. Ogeron, and members of the staff. The meeting was called to order. The Executive Committee examined and authorized payments of invoices for the current month, including supplemental payroll and travel expenses. There were no member concerns at the time. Do I have a motion to accept the report? Motion by Mr. Dehart, second by Mr. Voisin. Any public notice? Any public comments? Mr. Dehart?
No, ma'am. Thank you.
Mr. Voisin? Any other board members? Any objections? None heard, so ordered. There being no further business to come before the Executive Committee, the meeting was adjourned at 8:14 p.m. Item 9, Superintendent's Agenda. Mr. Ogeron.
9A1, matter pertaining to contract extension for project management services with Hammerman and Gainer LLC. The recommendation is that the board approve and accept an extension of the existing construction project management services contract with Hammerman and Gainer LLC under the same compensation limit of 4% of each final approved project worksheet, PW, at the same hourly rates as the existing contract for only the current repair projects at H.L. Bourgeois and South Terrebonne High Schools for a maximum period of 1 year from February 6, 2024 through February 6, 2025, or until the substantial completion of each individual project, if that substantial completion date is prior to February 6, 2025, pending board attorney review and approval.
So moved.
So moved, Mr. Harding.
Second.
Second by Mr. Dehart. Any public comment? Mr. Harding?
No, ma'am.
Mr. Dehart?
No, ma'am.
Any other board members? Mr. Ford?
So we knew this was coming up as far as, you know, the contracts were expiring. I did have some concerns. The last I had heard from our board counsel was a recommendation to not extend either one of the contracts due to failing to meet the criteria, or I don't remember the exact verbiage, but basically a breaching contract. So is this a situation where our board attorney is on board with this recommendation? Not to put you on the spot or anything, but.
Sure. Yeah, so I mean, this is a little bit different. They discuss it further, and the way that we're trying to do it is for those projects only. So it's not some of the issues that were present in the other one. So, you know, still has some stuff, but.
So it's a limited scope. We're just going to stick with what's already on the books
and finish it out. Okay, thank you.
Yep.
Mr. Boazza?
So it's just those two schools, HL and South Turbo.
Correct.
And it's till February 6, 2025, unless they complete before.
Correct. Both of them would have to finish before.
That date.
Yeah.
So let's say, because South Turbo is not projected to be completed, if I'm correct, until like June or whatever of 25, if I remember. So then what happens there? Do we?
At this time next year, we'll revisit.
We would revisit.
We'll revisit.
Okay, I'm just wanting to get some clarification. Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Any other comments? Any objections? None heard, so ordered.
Number two, matter
pertaining to the 24-25 school calendar. The recommendation is that the board approve and ratify the 2024-2025 school calendar with school year beginning August 1st, 2024 for employees, August 5th, 2024 for students, and ending May 23rd, 2025 with the following holidays to be observed during the school session: Labor Day, September 2nd, 2024, Fall Break, October 14th to the 15th, 2024, Thanksgiving, November 25th to the 29th, 2024, Christmas, December 23rd, 2024 through January 3rd, 2025. Students return on January 6, 2025. Dr. Martin Luther King's birthday observance, January 20th, 2025. Mardi Gras, March 3rd through the 7th, 2025. And Easter / spring break, April 18th through 25th, 2025. Fall makeup days, if needed, will be October 14th, 15th, and/or November 25th, 2024. Spring makeup days, if needed, will be March 6th and March 7th, 2025. Students' last day will be May 23rd, 2025. And teachers' last day will be May 26th, 2025.
So moved. Second.
Moved by Mr. Ford. Second by Mr. DeHart. Any public comment? Mr. Ford?
I just want to restate, it's obvious to us, but for everyone else to know that the employees of this district are presented with opportunities and options for calendars, and they vote on this and they chose these calendars. So, you know, this, we're putting it in the hands of our employees, and we're going off of their recommendation.
Yes, thank you, sir. Perfect.
Mr. DeHart?
Good comment.
Mr. Orgeron, you had to?
I just wanted to say what Mr. Ford said. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And I have a question. We have our 10 minutes still built in?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. 10 minutes, that provides 5 emergency days should we have hurricanes or anything. And we don't have to make up those days. It comes in very convenient.
Yeah.
All right.
Any other board members? Any objections? None heard, so ordered.
Item 3, personnel section, leave of absence. Number 1, family and medical leave. The recommendation is that the board approve a family and medical leave in accordance with policy file F-11.4A for Fabiola G. Brown, my modern inclusion teacher, Evergreen Junior High, beginning January 26, 2024 through May 3rd, 2024, medical.
So moved, Mr. Boisin.
Second.
Second by Mr. Cloche. Any public comment? Mr. Harding? I mean, Mr. Boisin, sorry. I'm giving you a promotion. Any comment? Mr. Cloche, any comment? Any other board members? Any objections? None of it, so ordered.
Okay. Item B are personnel actions for the period of December 29, 2023 through January 26, 2024. For your information, as provided for you board members.
That concludes our points in that section. Item number 10, under my name and individual board members, we need to vote as a board on our executive committee for the year. The recommendation is that the board approve the following appointments to the 2024 executive committee as presented by myself: Dr. Traha, president; Mr. Dean Boisin, vice president; and Mr. Michael LaGuard. Do I have a motion?
So moved,
Mr. Harding. Second by Mr. Cloche. Any public comment? Mr. Harding?
Right.
Mr. Cloche? Any other board members? Any objections? None heard, so ordered. Item B is informational committee appointments. We just went through the committee for the executive committee. Finance, insurance, and Section 16 lands will be chaired by Mr. Ford this year. Vice chair will be Don Crowdis, and the member is Bud Cloche. Buildings, Food Service, and Transportation. The chairperson is Dane Voisin, the vice chair, Mr. Michael Lagarde, and member, myself. Education, Technology, and Policy, the chairwoman, Debbie Benoit, vice chairman, Gregory Harding, and the member, Roger DeHart. Legislature Liaison, Debbie Benoit. Our advisory members for Health and Hospitalization, Crystal Elmer, Melissa Swallow, Claudette McKay, Selena Abair, Connie Sehan, Catherine Rochelle, Karen Nakan-Dusenberry, Gwen Stevens, and Curtis Constranish. We have any of these ladies and gentlemen here this evening?
Curtis is the only one.
Except for Mr. Constranish. The tentative schedule is the next item as presented for next school year for our dates for our meetings. Per board action on February 5th, 2019, the school board meetings will be held on the first Tuesday with the exception of holidays each month at 6 p.m. in the boardroom. Standing committees will meet at 5 p.m. on the third Tuesday of each Monday of each month on a rotating basis with exceptions for holidays in the boardroom. And those are listed, those dates are listed for you there. One recommendation, item D, that we reschedule the school board meeting of April 2nd to April 9th. April 2nd, the schools are closed and we will not be in session because of the Easter holidays. The agenda deadline to remain on noon, March 27 for agenda items. Do I have a motion? Mr. Voisin, second by Mr. Harding. Any public comment? Mr. Voisin? Mr. Harding? Any other board members? No any objections? None heard, so ordered. Wow. There being all agenda items were addressed and there's no further business to become before the Terrebonne Parish School Board, the meeting is adjourned.
Motion to adjourn.
That was